everyone, Miss Tiffany here again from Masonville Cove, and I'm here with our STEAM activity box, and I'm doing our final letter of STEAM, which is M for Mathematics. Mathematics has a special place in my heart, and even though it might not be the most favorite subject to a lot out there, it is a favorite subject to a lot out there as well, including me. So math is used everywhere. It's not just used in the classroom when we're dealing with numbers and addition, multiplication, division. We actually use it a lot, not only with dealing with money, but dealing with cooking, dealing with sports, all these other different disciplines. But how can we use math when we're working with science? And it's very important as scientists when we're making all these observations to record our data. And we've been doing that throughout the week. And here we're going to be using a special graph called a bar graph to just have another visual way of displaying the data that we collect. So M for mathematics in our STEAM activity box. So today we're going to be graphing observations we see outside our window, maybe from a picture. And we want to be graphing living and non-living things. So thinking about characteristics of living things, well, I'm a living thing, and one thing that I know that I have in common with other living things is that I grow. I'm not the same size I was when I was younger. So that might be a characteristic I'll be looking for in some of the things I check outside my window. I want to make sure that I take my sheet with me so that way I can list what I see outside my window for some of the other things I'm going to have to do later in this activity. Let's go take a look. Now that we decided to come upstairs, I decided to pick this window in the vestibule for my observation window. And I decided to pick this window because I come here every day. When I come to work at Masonville and I pass by this window and look out this window every time I leave before I get my car. So now that we did step one, step two is list at least 15 things you see in that environment. So I am going to look out this window and look at 15 different things. So as I'm looking outside my window, the first thing that comes to my mind is those cars. We have a lot of cars in our parking lot today, so I'm going to put that as my first thing down here on my table under step two. And another thing that comes to mind is the pavement that the cars are sitting on. There's just a lot of it. There's a lot of impervious ground here. So I'm going to write that down in my second space. Keeping these cars safe, that gate. I'm gonna put that down as something I see in my environment. Next to the gate, I see a big, beautiful tree, so I'm gonna put that down next to the gate. And I also see a bench underneath that tree that looks pretty nice. The bench isn't sitting on the pavement though, so I wanna write down that it's sitting down on the grass. If I look down below me, I can actually see that there's grass and I can see the soil, so I'm gonna put down soil. I also see some rocks and some plants. But if I look over to the right, I also see a person. Wait, how is that? It's Miss Mel! Look with her magnifying glass. It looks like she's working on her technology activity kit. Awesome job. Well, let's go downstairs and move on to step three, circling the living things you found with a crayon. I only did 10 for the sake of time, so I'm gonna start circling my living things in my table here. So cars, I know, is not living. Grass, living. Pavement, no. Soil, no. Gate, no. Rocks, no. Tree, yeah. Plants, yeah. Miss Val, yeah. And a bench, no, that was man-made. So after looking at how many things I did, I found 4 living things in my environment.
And doing the quick math in my head, I know that that means that there were 6 non-living things in my environment. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, step 5, you want to make your bar graph to help to communicate your results in a different way. So, looking at my graph here, my environment was outside Masonville's vestibule. So, I'm going to write that as my title. Vestibule window, and I'm writing in crayon, but you'll probably write with your pencil that's in your packet here. I want to make sure I color my key, so I'm going to make my living things green because green reminds me of the plants and things that I saw that was living. My non-living things are going to be blue here, but you have some other colors you can pick. So now that I added my title and I colored my key, I need to make sure I number my y-axis. And this right here is going to be my x-axis. This is going to be my y-axis, also known as the vertical axis. Before I start recording my data here, I recorded 10 things, so I'm gonna make mine go up to 10. When you're doing yours, you'll probably wanna go up to 15 since you have 15 different things that you wanna be observing. You want to try to make sure that these marks are equally placed. And actually, you have this ruler that you're using. So I'm doing it the quick way, not so organized way, but as scientists. And if you want to be very precise with your graphs and share your results and communicate your data in the most accurate way, you're going to want to use the ruler to separate those spaces pretty equally. But you can see now that I eyeballed it, I did pretty well of a job keeping it about a half a centimeter apart to go up to 10. So I'm gonna use the data here that I collected. I used the space to just draw a couple different things. As you can see, I drew and I wrote what I drew. I'm not a great artist, but that was my tree, that was my gate. And I found 4 living things. So I'm going to go to living. I'm going to count up 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm going to make a little mark there. For non-living, I found 6 non-living things. So I'm going to go all the way up to 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And this is going to be about right here. And again, you have your ruler. I haven't taken mine out of this nice packaging, but I will. And I'm gonna go to 6, I'm gonna line it up, and yep, make it about here. Now for our bar graphs, like you see in the bar graph video, you're going to basically just turn these lines into little rectangles, and you can make them skinny, you can make them small, but you wanna be pretty consistent. So that your data looks nice and neat. So again, 4 non-living things, line it up with the 4. And then I am gonna color these according to how I made them in my key. So living, this rectangle would be green and this one would be blue. So after you write down your observations, after you graph your data, you want to take a look at your data and take things a little bit farther. Interpret your data and think about what might be going on in your environment, or how might these living and non-living things interact in your environment to change your environment or how you interact with it. So that's M. Congratulations on finishing your STEAM activity box. That's awesome. Just like the other activities, if you can, please share your data, your observations at hashtag MCove2Go on any social media platform. We'd love to see what's going on in your environment compared to ours. So have a great day.